If testosterone is given to younger men who, I don't know, want to be better at football or want to be better athletes, and does it affect their fertility or affect them from a negative health standpoint?
Yes, and that's another take-home point I would take home was the testosterone on the young people. There, at one point, there was a study came out that 40% of high school athletes were exposed to some kind of testosterone steroids.
Wow.
Because at that level, we don't do as much strenuous testing of the athlete, not at college level or professional level. So unfortunately, the abuse of anabolic steroids is actually more common than we care to admit, and not just for cyclists and things like that. As part of my job, I do see male with infertility issues. A lot of the guys do come in, haven't been exposed to testosterone. And it's kind of counterintuitive because we think testosterone is important for sperm production, giving you more must be better, right? And that's what a lot of the men's health clinics, that's what they treat men, give them testosterone. Unfortunately, when a man is exposed to testosterone, our body get lazy. So we start making our own testosterone, which in turn start making our own sperm. So at one point, testosterone was actually studied as a male birth control. And then what I found was that giving a healthy college man testosterone, in 6 months, we pretty much sterilized them. So
I think it's really important for college students who might be thinking about this to hear that they can become sterile or infertile by taking this medicine.
Exactly. And then luckily for us, there are ways to turn their body back on. Because I described to the guys is that your body is an off mode. Because your body's used to being exposed to testosterone.
We have to turn it back
on. Exactly, turn it back on. But unfortunately, even though 80% of the guys we can turn back on, they're usually not at 100% of what their fertility was. So it is a partial recovery, but at least it is not an irreversible damage. So that's the
If you are healthy and your body's making the right amount of testosterone, supplementing really doesn't make sense.
Yeah. No. And there are other ways that I do see young men with hormone imbalance, and there are other ways to boost a man's endogenous or their own testosterone by using other medications. And clomiphene citrate is one of the medications that we commonly use, and how it works is that it tricks a man's brain that to think that we haven't made enough testosterone. So the brain sends more signals down below the belt, so that way you push your testicle to work harder. So that's one way that we can boost a man's testosterone naturally.